sweet tooth? Well, good news. You have an excuse to indulge because it's National Cookie Day.
Oh, that's such good news. And joining us with some delicious inspiration is Danielle Famaro, author of Add This to Your Plate, Mastering the Essentials in Cooking, Nutrition, and Fitness. Hey there, Danielle.
Good morning.
Hey, everybody. Hi, Alana. Hi, Patrick. How are you folks doing today?
Excellent.
We're excited because it's National Cookie Day.
Best day of the year.
Yeah.
Yay, I know. So, have you guys ever had Italian Anisette cookies before?
Okay. True confession, I believe I used to have them sometimes when I was little at my mom's friend's house. They were like the brand that were shaped like S's. They were hard. Right?
Yes.
Yep. Store-bought.
Well, they could be that shape, absolutely. Yeah, and it's funny you said holiday because these are the perfect holiday cookie. I cook them every single year at Christmas time, and they just, it's something nostalgic about the smell. And I will tell you, you can buy these in the store. You've probably seen them. But once you try this recipe, you will probably never buy the store-bought ones again because there is, again, a secret ingredient here that I don't think the store is using because I haven't discovered a store yet that makes them like this. So, are you ready?
The one thing I love about Danielle coming on the show is she's always got that secret ingredient.
Yes.
So, show us what you got.
We need it.
I know. I feel like since we're going to have kids, everything has to be like, I have a secret surprise with you guys. I got a secret ingredient. It's like part of being a parent, having secrets. But I'm really excited to show you this. So, I'll get right into it. We'll start, of course, we have a dry mixture and a wet mixture. So, with a dry mixture, I have 3.5 cups of all-purpose flour. Next, I'm going to add 5 tablespoons of baking powder. Now, make sure it's powder, okay, and not soda. They're not the same thing. Everyone gets confused. And then next, 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And that's it. That's our dry mixture. So we just sift this together so it's nice and blended, and then we'll start the wet mixture. So with our wet mixture, I have 1 stick of butter and 1/4 cup of a coconut oil melted. I've already melted for you folks, so we'll put that right in the dish. And then I've got 3/4 cup of sugar, so white sugar. And I'm going to blend this for a minute just so that it's nice and blended. And then we need 4 eggs. So typically I'll put 1 egg in at a time and I'll blend it. But today, just to speed things up, I've already whipped them up for you.
So Danielle, let me ask you again. You're going by hand. Is it easier to mix by hand with a whisk or use a stand-up blender?
So for me, the only time I use like a blender is if it's a really hard thing to mix. Like when I make the biscottis, there's no way, and you know what, I'm gonna be able to knead that dough with my hands. So I'll use a mixer when I feel like I'm not strong enough to do it. But with these, I don't think it's really necessary because if you over mix, you can make things tough, so you do have to be a little careful with that. So I don't think it's necessary with this, really.
Okay.
But that's a great question. Are you ready for that secret ingredient?
Yes.
Bring it on, girl.
Can you guess it? I know. I wish you could see.
I can't guess.
I would have no idea. I'm not a baker.
Okay, I'll guess coconut.
I know.
Oh, you already have coconut oil. I don't know.
Okay. All right. I won't keep you in suspense here, but this is so important. This is anisette oil, not extract. It's the pure oil. So you may have to go order it online or at a specialty shop, but I use 1.5 teaspoons. If you don't use the oil, it's not going to taste the same. Okay, so oil, and then I add 1 teaspoon of vanilla, and that's it. There's my wet mixture. Okay, next step is combine both together, okay? And this is really the last step. We're going to form our dough. So what do you guys think so far? Do you think this is pretty simple so far?
Very simple. It looks like it comes together quickly.
And Danielle, let me ask again. Yeah. If I remember from my youth, anise is more like a licorice flavor, correct?
Yeah, awesome question. It is. And you know what? Licorice isn't for everybody. So if at any time you feel like, I don't think I'm going to use licorice, what you can actually do is you can use any extract. If you want to use lemon or you want to just do vanilla because you don't like that licorice flavor, that's fine. And that's the wonderful thing about cookies is you can change the flavor just by the extract. But again, use the oil if you are going to do it. And once you do, this is what the dough will look like. I've already done the dough for you. So if to show you this, we roll them up in a little ball, and we'll put these on a tray lined with parchment paper. So I've got one behind me. You put them in the oven. Now here's how fast they cook. 375, 6 to 8 minutes, and done. And when they're done, are you ready?
Yes.
They're not frosted yet. I'm going to do that part with you. They will look just like this. Now you know they're done when you flip them over and they're little light brown and golden. Okay. That's when you know they're done. So are you ready for the frosting part?
Yes, it's the best part, Danielle. Let's face it.
I don't know, the sprinkles.
You know we all be like licking this bowl right now. Yes. If you were with me. So this is easy. All the frosting is 3 cups of confection sugar, a few tablespoons of milk, and then you have frosting. That's how easy it is. So here's the key. You have to let your cookies cool off before you do the frosting. If you don't, the frosting will literally melt right off the cookie. I can't tell you how many people I've given this recipe to, and they're like, how come my frosting melted off? I'm like, did you let them cool like I said? And they're like, I was like, there you go. You got to listen. And then let's sprinkle some love on top.
Look at that.
They look so beautiful. Very festive, Danielle.
Here you go, guys. Yeah. And I'll try to put them a little closer to you. And then, of course, if you want to get all fancy, you can put them on a tray and show off when everyone comes over.
That's right. Well, Danielle Famaro, I want to thank you so much for coming here and sharing your recipe with us.
And celebrating Cookie Day.
Yes.
Thanks, Danielle. Be well.
Have a wonderful, delicious week, everybody.
Yeah.